It's another tutorial Tuesday. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. And for those of you that are new to this channel, my name is Vera Sax and your tutor for the day is Mo Sax. Today we are still on our series Jazz Improvisation, and guess what? We are going to be jazzing the team to the next level, Lydia mode. Stay tuned and keep learning.
Welcome to Jazz Tutorial. In our Tutorial Tuesday, we have been looking at jazz improvisation. We started by doing the minor mode, we've done the minor mode, we've done the Mixolydian mode, and then today I want to quickly look at the Lydian mode improvisation. I'm taking it gradually because actually I can teach you all the mode put together in a class, but I don't want to confuse you. You take class, each mode one by one. When we are done with all the modes, we can now put everything together and I'll now show you how this mode relates one to another. So stay tuned in this channel and then you'll be glad you did. Now today, Lydian scale is what we are going to use to improvise over the soundtrack that we are releasing today. The Lydian scale is the same thing as your major scale. The only thing is that the fourth note, you are just sharpening that note. I'm on key F on the piano, but on the E flat instrument, you have it as your key D. Now, D Lydian scale is. Do, re, mi, fi, sol, la, ti, do. Do, ti, la, sol, fi, mi, re, do. Of course, you should be able to go up, go down, go up like that, two octave, all your octave, all your registers. I'm like. That is your Lydian scale. Now, the Lydian scale, the relative key that you can use when you are on key D is your key A. Your key A, all you need to do is just to play it from fa to fa, fa to fa, fa to fa. Just like the relative minor is la to la. On your Lydian, it will now be your fa to fa. Mixolydian that we did last week was your sol to sol of the relative key. Now, the relative key of this particular Lydian scale is your key A. Now, you are just turning your do to your fa of that. Just as you turn your do to your la of your relative minor, here you are turning your fa, which is your do, which is your D, you turn it to a fa. When you run it from fa, you will land on your A as your do. But since you are not on the major scale of your key A, you are actually landing on your home note or your root note, which is your D, making it from fa to fa. So if I want to run it in my mind, I can be on key A. I'll just take it as fa sol la ti do re mi fa mi re do ti la sol fa fa sol la ti do re mi fa fa sol la ti do re mi fa. It's the same thing. Since I only have one note that is taking me out of my major scale, I don't need to use the relative. I just take it as my fi in that original, my main key. So here I'm not interpreting it relatively. I'm interpreting it actually on my key D. So I remain on my key D and just know that what I am using, I'm adding my fi instead of my fa, substituting it. But once in a while, depending on how you have mastered your key A, you can actually begin to play on your key A, but knowing that what you are landing on your key D of your key A, which is your fa of that. So you are starting from fa sol la ti do re mi fa, not do re mi fa sol la ti do, if not take it to another key. I hope you understand this relative of it. I explained this more when I was teaching on minor mode, because while we did that extensively on your minor, because you have so many notes taking you out of the normal. But here you only have one note. Mixolydian only have one note. So instead of doing it relatively, I just decided to stay on that key. So here I can decide to stay on my D, knowing that what is my do re mi fi sol la ti do. Just stay on your key on this particular Lydian scale, because it's only one note that's taking out of the diatonic scale. So practice it up and down. For those of you on tenor, for those of you on tenor, since we're on key F, you just go ahead and play your G here. So G is. It's the same thing. Make sure you permutate it. Make sure you practice it up and down. And then get some licks that you can get from my improvisation. Download the soundtrack because we're putting it as usual in our channel in Reverb Nation. So you go ahead and just download it. Go ahead and practice it. Play it with your headphone. Play it in your home theater. Use it as your rehearsal tool. And then practice. Make sure you stay on the scale. Make sure you don't leave the scale. Another thing is that you're going to be seeing me doing some modulation while I'm improvising. And I think I need to show you, but it's a class that is coming ahead of us. So where you go, you play a note, you go up the next key, you play a note, the same thing you played, you go up again, you play the same thing, you go up again, you play the same thing. So you get it as, for example, so you go up, you do the same thing, you go up, you do the same thing. Same thing as coming down, you do something, you go down, you do something like. So you just go like, you know, well, it's a class on its own. So, but I actually used it. I don't want you to be wondering, he said we should stay on the scale. Why did you do that? Well, what I just did was, I was just modulating the Lydian scale, and then I made sure I quickly land on my note so that it doesn't take me too off. So that's what I did. If you didn't get it, don't worry. Stay on the Lydian mode while you're improvising. As we continue to go, I'll show you how to modulate right on your improvisation. You just do something, you modulate, do something, you modulate, you do something. The same thing, but you're just modulating it, full tone modulation. Sometimes you're just doing a minor mode, circle, and circle like that, circle of fifth, circle of fourth. But I'm going to be teaching it on this channel. I hope you stay tuned to the end of these classes that we are doing. And then don't be in a hurry, just continue and gradually. For today, just download this track, stay on Lydian scale. So presently, I'm going to be playing something on the background. The soundtrack is going to be playing, and I'm going to use this scale that I've taught you to improvise on it, expecting that you will do yours also. All right, join me right now. Thank you. hope you like that. Just go ahead and do the same. I believe you can do it. The only thing you need to eliminate is fear. The fear of improvising. Sometimes you want to improvise. You're afraid. You feel you miss your note. Don't be afraid. Practice makes perfect. Now, the notes of that, of the soundtrack, if you notice the chord was La Fi Fa Do Ti Mi La Fi. So your note is. So it was that note that is Fi that you need to target with your Lydian scale. Because of that Fi, you just target that part of the chord and then you start running those Lydian scale. That's that. Then we have a melody for this soundtrack. For those of you that are from Nigeria, there's this song we sing. Alade Ogo, oh, Alade Ogo, oh. That's just the melody I picked. Mi so so do mi re do la re do. That was just the notes of that melody. Okay, so I believe you can do it. Any other song that you feel can enter the Lydian, you can use it. Choose a melody of your own and then just make sure you are on scale. Later, you now realize that when you now begin to see a chord coming and it's adding and it's sharpening your fourth note, it tells you that see Lydian scale is the scale to go for at that particular point of your chord progression. Alright guys, Verasax is coming back to give you a closing remark. Bye!
Yeah! Oh, Father! That was woo-hoo. That class was so powerful. I hope you learned a lot today. Okay, make sure you rehearse that. The soundtrack will be on the description box below. Download it, follow the link, rehearse with it. You just notice tremendous changes in your play. Okay, and make sure you subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next Tuesday. Bye.